Thank you. Thank you. Welcome to the 159th New Philadelphia High School Class of 2023 graduation. Please bow your head and join me in a prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for the experiences and memories that have been crafted over the course of the past 4 years. Thank you for providing each of us with a lasting foundation to move forward into the next chapter of our lives and allowing us all to gather amongst friends and family to celebrate this achievement. I pray that you watch over each of us as we spread in different directions and help us to achieve success and satisfaction in our lives. Thank you, Lord, for our time together in New Philadelphia, and help us to forever remember these past years. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please have a seat. I would like to introduce the class of 2023 president, Brad Waugh.
Never mind. As Nathaniel said, I am the class president of the 2023 graduating class. And I knew I had to write a speech, so I wrote one in August because I got really bored one day. And it was a good speech. Then I wrote two more because I got bored again. And they were both really good speeches. But what I wanted to say in August now, that one was about the future, but really I'd like to talk about the past and what we're leaving behind. I was thinking back to my childhood and all of the movies and cartoons that I watched and all the books that I read, and the one that I keep coming back to is by one of my favorite authors, C.S. Lewis. He wrote The Chronicles of Narnia, which, in my opinion, is one of the greatest stories ever written. Specifically, I'd like to talk about the second book, Prince Caspian. The story is about change. The four children from the first book return to Narnia, but it's not the Narnia that they left. Their grand palace that they lived in, the thrones they sat on, all of their friends were gone. There were new rules, new people, and new problems. Lewis writes, "Day by day, nothing changes. But when you look back, everything is different. I look at yesterday, It really doesn't feel any different from today. I look back at last week, and it doesn't feel much different from this week. But I look back last month, last year, and it was all different. When I was younger, I wanted nothing more than to be a grown-up. And now that I'm a little more grown up, I want nothing more than to be a little kid again. I've learned that the most childish thing a person can do is grow up too fast. Those kids wanted to go back to Narnia and relive their old adventures. But C.S. Lewis wrote that things will never happen the same way twice. If I was given the chance to go back and do it all again, go back to Sunday school and make crafts with Marilyn, or go to the playground at South Elementary and play tag, I don't think I would. I would keep it all just the way that it is, the imperfect picture to look back on with a lighter heart. And now, at the risk of redundancy, I'll leave you with one more quote from C.S. Lewis, not from Prince Caspian, but from a simple letter he wrote to a friend. There are far, far better things than those we leave behind. Congratulations to all my fellow graduates. I would now like to introduce the Student Council President, Marilyn Stokey.
Board of Education, Administration, Class of 2023, and Quaker Nation. It is quite a humbling experience and an honor to speak to you today as your Student Council President. I don't anticipate my speech today will change the world, but I certainly hope it reveals to you some of the lessons you taught me over the last 18 years as both a student and a citizen of this wonderful community. Let's begin. Quality, the degree of excellence of something. Uniqueness, being particularly remarkable or special. Ambition, having or showing a strong desire and determination to succeed. Knowledge, to be intelligent and well-informed. Eagerness, having or showing an impatient or enthusiastic desire or interest. Responsiveness, to be active, aware, compassionate, conscious, reactive, and receptive. And spirit, to be full of energy and determination. Quality, Q. Uniqueness, U. Ambition, A. Knowledge, K. Eagerness, E. Responsiveness, R. And spirit, S. What does that spell? Quakers. Each of these words play an integral role in what it truly means to be a Quaker. In terms of quality, our class, in particular, had many quality wins against our rival across the river. The football team gave us a particularly entertaining experience. Shout out Nathaniel Demuth. I don't think any of us will ever forget that moment. Now, of course, it was a team effort, but hey, if scoring the field goal to win the Dover Philly football game was easy, everyone would do it. The volleyball team defeated Dover twice this season, ending the games in 3 and 5 sets. One of the times, sending us to the Elite Eight for the tournament run. The boys' cross-country team defeated Dover at the district meet, while the girls' and boys' basketball teams and the boys' baseball team defeated Dover 2 times each as well. And finally, the most Dover came from the boys' track team. It's safe to say that this was a momentous year for quality wins for Quaker athletics when it comes to beating the Tornadoes. As for uniqueness, what better example can we have than to recognize the record for graduating the most hankies in one class? Take a bow, Josh, Jonah, and Jerry. Continuing on, our class found ourselves in an incredibly unique position in the spring of 2020 upon the ending of our freshman year. I think we can all agree that it still feels like yesterday when we found out that we were getting 2 weeks off of school because of the COVID-19 pandemic. Our high school experience was altered immensely, and we became the guinea pigs for an entirely new form of learning. For almost 2 years, we knew each other by the expressions in our eyes and the muffled voices from behind the masks and plexiglass that surrounded us like a force field. Obviously, growing up comes with periodically learning to adapt to spontaneous changes and becoming more responsible, but I don't think any of us could have guessed the catalyst for the change would be a COVID-19 pandemic. That being said, I could not have asked for a better group of individuals to be surrounded by when going through that experience, even if it was from 6 feet apart. Ambition. Ambition is the essence of being a Quaker. We wear our red and black as a badge of honor. We know our next step. Is to go out into the world and make a difference. We know we will always remember where we came from and the gift that New Philadelphia was to each of us. If we happen to be recognized for our achievement someday, we will reflect on the drive and ambition Quaker Nation instilled during our time here. Knowledge. This is the very foundation for why you sent us to school for 13 years. Within the class of 2023, there are 28 students who achieved the ranking of summa cum laude, 20 who earned magna cum laude, and 19 who earned cum laude. As a class, we also received $246,000 from incredible contributors to the Quaker Foundation, along with the other scholarships from very generous community organizations, rewarding our hard work both inside and outside of the classroom. Please allow me to pause for a second and reflect on that last paragraph. That is crazy. Over $246,000 to the class of 2023. How can any of us say we did not grow up in a special place? What other community gives its students a $246,000 head start in life? To the Quaker Foundation, to the community, and to Quaker Nation, on behalf of the senior class of 2023, allow me to say thank you, thank you, thank you for this incredible gift. Eagerness. The class of 2023 is driven, intelligent, and strong. We know we are naive to what the world has in store for us, but we are eager to take on the challenge in front of us. Eagerness creates energy. And if we remain eager in the things that we do, we, as a class, have the opportunity to do great things. Responsiveness. We have learned in life it is not so much what happens to you, but rather how you respond. For example, through the unique challenges we experienced in a centenary pandemic, we adapted to new challenges virtually overnight. We learned what N95 meant, how to do a Zoom call, to call in sick to school and not be asked to come back tomorrow, but instead be told, Take a week off, no hurry. You take care of you. Are all of us scarred in some way or another from this experience? Sure. But through it all, we fought the temptation of being bitter and chose to respond by being better. And finally, spirit. Who does not know what the Quaker spirit is all about? You could argue that this is the most important quality of all when it comes to being a Quaker. Whether it's sports, band, choir, art, debate team, academic challenge, or the Project Lead the Way community showcase, shout out to my dad, you could always count on a 2023 senior to be in the student section or in attendance, and the rest of the Quaker Nation rooting on the Quakers. Each of these words discussed should remain in our blood as we enter the next chapter of our lives. Cheesy, I know, but hey, we didn't come this far to only come this far. So, as we come to the end of our final last and approach the nearing of our new first, I challenge each of us to do things with quality, to be unique, remain ambitious, stay knowledgeable, continue to be eager and responsive, and always stay spirited. Woody Hayes says it best when he states, "You'll find out that nothing that comes easy is worth a dime." I guess in today's economy, we should say that nothing that comes easy is worth a dollar. You get the picture. Lastly, I am so thankful to have grown up in such a supportive and giving community that has taught me everything I know. Though I could say thank you to everyone in this stadium for impacting me in some ways throughout my young adulthood, there are a few individuals who have helped shape me into the person I am today that I would like to thank specifically. Coach Claxon, thank you for giving me a greater love for the sport of soccer and for making the process of diving on the ground for a ball much more enjoyable. Mrs. Wallach, thank you for reminding me to relax every once in a while and remember that it's okay to laugh a little. Well, a lot, actually. Mr. Furby and Ms. Pruka, thank you for allowing me to be a part of athletics and arts at the same time and encouraging me to remain active throughout my high school experience. Without the both of you, I would not have been able to be a female version of Troy Bolton. Mrs. Lewis, thank you for your continual daily guidance in providing me with the skills to be able to write this speech. And my biggest thank you goes to my mom, dad, Ellie, Emma, Mitchell, and of course, Augie. Thank you for always pushing me to be the best possible version of myself. You truly are my biggest fans, and I'm so thankful to call you my family. And overall, thank you, New Philadelphia. Throughout my time here, I have been provided with the most amazing opportunities, and I hope to one day pay forward that same gift to others. So, class of 2023, I will leave you with a simple piece of advice. Remember where you came from and always continue to show up. If you ever find yourself feeling unsure or in doubt, remember, just be a Quaker. Thank you. I would like to introduce the National Honor Society. I would like to introduce the National Honor Society President, Cambry Mushrush.
Class of 2023, when we first got our email accounts in elementary school, I remember how far 2023 seemed from that moment. And now, we are sitting here in our caps and gowns, about to walk across this stage to receive our diploma. I want to thank our families who have helped us arrive at this moment, who have supported us through the struggle and celebrated our success with us. I'd like to thank our coaches who have taught us the value of hard work, to believe in ourselves, and to push ourselves to new heights. I'd like to thank our teachers who have made such an impact on us, who have helped us grow academically and supported and outside the classroom. Today, we celebrate all we've accomplished throughout our time here at NPHS and what we will accomplish going forward. But before we look ahead, let us look back at our journey that took us here. I can remember back to South Elementary Preschool when my favorite activity was singing songs on the carpet and getting more paint on my clothes than on my paper. I can remember career day when we dressed up as firefighters, doctors, veterinarians, and even hula hoop teachers. That one was me. Now, as I look at our senior class, I see future nutritionists, accountants, cosmetologists, musicians, authors, welders, educators, biologists. I see men and women entering the armed forces. I see students pursuing research, studying abroad, and entering the workforce. And in the stands, I see parents, friends, and family that are so proud of each and every one of us. I look at how much things have changed, and yet how much they haven't. We still never miss a chance to cheer on our Quakers. We still decorate our teachers' doors for Dover Philly Week, and Mr. Price still walks the halls of the high school every once in a while. I'm sure you can recall amazing memories from these past years as a student, but tonight, we are leaving this stadium as New Philadelphia alumni, joining thousands of adults who have gone before us, who have paved the way for where we are right now. As we go forward, let us be reminded to write our plans in pencil. Sometimes in the moment, it's hard to see the bigger picture. Sometimes things happen that we could have never expected, and it throws off all of our plans. In that case, we have two options. We can fight it, or we can roll with it. You can't control what happens in this lifetime, but you can control how you respond to it. Choose to make the best out of every situation and live every day like it's your last. Write your plans in pencil and give God the pen. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Jeremiah 29:11. As we move forward, don't forget to pause and reflect once in a while. Look at how far you have come and look forward to who you have yet to be. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2023. Board President, Mr. Tom McMath, and Board of Education members, administration, teachers, staff, parents, and honored guests. It is with great pleasure I present to you, as candidates for graduation, New Philadelphia High School's class of 2023.
Mr. Todd McMath and members of the New Philadelphia City School Board, these candidates have completed the requirements needed for graduation as set forth by the Ohio Department of Education and the New Philadelphia Board of Education. Therefore, in accordance with the laws of the state of Ohio, I recommend that each graduate be presented with a diploma by the Board of Education as evidence of their accomplishments. Will the first row of candidates please stand and come forward to be recognized?
Nathaniel Michael Curtis Demuth. Brad Thomas Waugh. Marilyn Grace Stokey. Cambry Ann Mushrush. Thaddeus James Van Arsdalen. Javier Ahanel Sante. Amber Lynn Albritton. Elijah Lee Marquise Alexander. Caitlin Audrey Armstrong. Brittany Brianna Bailey. Alexandria Romaine Baker. Aiden James Baker. Nicholas Michael Barker. Alden Joseph Barnhart. Seamus Lane Brown. Trevor Michael Bean. Trinity Evelyn Bennington. Christina Dogmawit Behera. Kale Allen Blake. Connor Lee Brinton. Elena May Brown. Maddox Lane Brown. Caroline Elaine Bucklew. Hannah Nicole Burke. Ashton Lynn Carlisle. Allison Taylor Carpenter. Maria Rosalinda Castro Lux. Cameron John Clarkson. Thomas Ty Smith Cook. Brooke Reese Corbin. Nevaeh Rain Courtney. Samantha Lynn Courtney. Brooklyn Larie Crowell. Christian Allen Davlin. Casey Lynn Dawson. Madison Marie Deegan. David Michael Dybel. Emma Jean Demuth. Haley Ryan DeRamo. Daniel Armand DiDonato. Javen Michael Doss. Caleb Wasian Durda. Abigail Jane Edwards. Jillian Elizabeth Edwards. Jordan Christopher Ike. Raiden Gage Estep. Kellen Irene Fossil. Anthony Frederick Fields. Tegan Cade Finnicum. Cheyenne Sky Fenton. Alicia Diana Nicole Ford. Elijah Robert Forrest. Brennan Forrest Fox. Joseph Edward Fulton. Morgan Riley Garbrandt. Logan William Garner. Rosemary Gonzalez. Riley Elizabeth Gruhl. Kaylee Marie Hall. Jackson Robert Harmon. Ariana Lachelle Harris. Jeremiah James Henke. Jonah Richard Henke. Joshua Paul Henke. Carlos Alexander Hernandez. Alexander Nicholas Hirschberger Perez. Nadia Maley Hines. Lily K. Hissner. Grant Isaac Hopkins. Michael Allen Hudson. Benjamin Russell Jeffers. Mallory Grace Johnson. Mitchell Aaron Johnson. Meadow K. Jones. Tori Elaine Kaiser. Christian Eduardo Sica Mejia. Britton Blue Candle. Travis John Kaiser. Tate Thomas Casper. Kyler Ethan Curtis Keck. Jada Nicole Kelly. Adeline Marine Kendall. Americus Marie Kearns. Bailey Thomas Knowles Baker. Bryant Robert Corns. Erica Marie Kugler. Aiden Michael Kyle. Triska Lynn Leslie. Cassidy Marie Lowe's. Madison Olivia Mann. Connor Jacob Marshall. Madison K. Martineau. Mason Alec McClelland. Caitlin Elizabeth McCray. Dakota Lane McCune. Avery Elizabeth Miser. Emma K. Menapace. Jonathan Sebastian Mendoza Jones. Jaden Nicole Miller. Summer Savannah Moss. Katie Michelle Milius. Noah Harrison O'Brien. Pablo Palico Rohope. Riley Jade Pershing. Miranda Ann Phillips. Ethan Michael Pierce. Sarah Aaron Ramey. Riley Ann Randolph. Dylan William Reffitt. Alex Logan Reynolds. Erica Lynn Rice. Gabrielle Christine Reason. Sophia Renee Riker. Lachey Marie Nicole Robinson. Jacob Thomas Roman Willie. Gabriel Allen Salazar. Lydia Arlene Salazar. Gracie Ann May Sanner. Brody Matthew Shad. Madison Elizabeth Scott. Kiera Marie Shotwell. Michaela Faye Schreffler. Haley Grace Shuck. Piper Larissa Smith. Tyler Jordan Staley. Eliana Zion Stefan. Juliana Renee Steiner. Caden Michael Stewart. Rocky Warner Stahl. Titus Ocean Sezi. Derek Mason Tarazi. Connor James Tetzloff. Curtis Ryan Tetzloff. Simon Ian Thomas. Evelyn Rose Tice. Abigail Virginia Trimble. Michaela Marie Tyson. Carter David Vandal. Jenny Karina Velasquez Ambrosio. Michael Gregory Vickers. Allison J. Vol. Daniel William Walker. William Owen Wallace. Emily Danielle Warner. Skylar Dean Watson. Jordan Nicole Weiss. Thank you. Hunter Lee Pardue. Brant Ulrich Wells. Gabriel Michael Wells. Gracie Elizabeth Wigfield. Sione Edwate Williams III. Kyla Starr Winters. Oslyn Jade Wren. Ella Christine Yoder. Karis Emmeline Young. Haley Jordan Zadra.
In Isaiah 40, 31, we are told, "But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint." Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the completion of another great academic year. Thank you for each and every person who has helped shape and mold us through our academic careers and giving us the opportunity to be here on this very important day. We are grateful for your guidance and love as we take our next steps on this journey called life. Please bless us as we end this chapter and begin the next. Help us use what we've learned while being here to truly become men and women who care for others. Help us make this world a better place to serve others selflessly and sacrificially help those who are in need, those who are less fortunate than ourselves. We know that this life will be filled with challenges. We will face pain and hardship. Many of us already have. So we ask you for your wisdom and strength. We ask you that you would help us patiently wait on you. Finally, Father, we thank you for this wonderful community you have placed us in. Though we are leaving campus, we know that we will always be a part of the New Philadelphia family. We ask that the bonds and relationships that have been created remain strong regardless of the distance. Thank you for all of the blessings, amazing memories, and experiences we've had.
Thank you.